Interstitial lung disease refers to a large group of respiratory diseases that cause inflammation and/or scarring in the lung tissue, which we call the interstitium. One of the subgroups of interstitial lung disease is the one related to occupational exposures, referred to as pneumoconiosis. We are exposed to many elements in our daily lives, including air pollution, vapors, and dusts. There are certain types of mineral dust exposures that have a known risk for causing pulmonary fibrosis, with patterns of lung injury that are well-defined. The type and timeline of exposure is an important piece of information when making the diagnosis of an occupational lung disease. Occupations such as coal mining, construction, and shipbuilding can be associated with pneumoconiosis, as can some jobs in manufacturing that involve crushing, cutting, or grinding. Those involving inhalation of mineral dusts are at the highest risk. The most common types of pneumoconiosis are asbestosis, silicosis, and coal workers' pneumoconiosis. Although workplace regulation has decreased the incidence of asbestosis, workers involved with abatements, grinding new brake pads, or production of materials such as roofing can still be exposed to damaging asbestos fibers. A history of work in construction, plumbing, automotive repair, or demolition up until the mid-20th century increases the risk of asbestosis. The more exposure a person has had, the higher the risk. And there's usually a lag time of several years between the exposure and the development of lung disease. Exposure to enclosed asbestos, such as what's behind a wall in a building where you work or live, or asbestos in the soil, does not cause disease. Stone cutting, masonry, and ceramics are some of the occupations at risk for development of silicosis. Coworkers are exposed to multiple elements, including coal dust, silica dust, and diesel exhaust. Coal workers' pneumoconiosis, also called CWP, can take two main forms: the simple form, which is often without symptoms, and complicated CWP, referred to as progressive massive fibrosis, which can cause progressive respiratory symptoms and dysfunction. Federal regulations and medical surveillance requirements attempt to limit exposure for coal workers and detect lung disease early when it develops. Symptoms of pneumoconiosis are often nonspecific and can include shortness of breath, cough, and fatigue. CWP also can present with bloody or black sputum or mucus production. Diagnostic evaluations include high-resolution computed tomography scans, what we call HRCT, and pulmonary function testing. Lung biopsy is rarely needed. There are no specific treatments for these occupational lung diseases, so management is supportive and can include supplemental oxygen if needed, pulmonary rehabilitation, and preventative measures, such as eliminating the dust exposure, smoking cessation, and appropriate vaccinations. Sometimes, if occupational lung disease is progressive, lung transplantation may be considered. Asbestosis is usually a slow, progressing form of pulmonary fibrosis, while silicosis can take an acute or a chronic form. Additional research is needed to better understand the prognostic and treatment implications of pulmonary fibrosis related to exposures. For more information and support, please visit pulmonaryfibrosis.org.